Welcome to another What's Up Wednesday. Glad to have you here live or watching the replay. Really appreciate that. My name is Scott. I do read the words on the screen carefully. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Go Small, Live Large, all about the van ownership and travel experience. We're going to recap some of what just happened the last few days. We had a big van baree in the Texas Hill Country, and it was so much fun. That was one of the video clips I'm going to share with you tonight. Just thank you for being here, and it's just always a blessing to have you trust us with our content in your ears and your eyes. I'm coming at you from Shiner, Texas tonight, and the reason it's I'm here is because I'm gonna get a hat and a shirt at the brewery tomorrow. I'm so excited, and again, it's just a delight to have you here with me tonight. Let me kind of show you what we're gonna do tonight. Here we go. And I'm gonna show you share some of the Texas Hill Country van baree we just had. I still can't get over it. It was so much fun. But no big topic tonight, so we're gonna say hi to a lot of our regulars and some of the new folks, and we want to get your questions answered as best I can. There's really not much I haven't done in my starting my sixth year last month of doing van life full-time travel. It's pretty crazy. Anything's on the table, don't be bashful. I do want to kind of call our attention to this. Last week we had a very different What's Up Wednesday. I kind of spoke from the heart because life is really short. I shared that my dad died 2 weeks ago tomorrow. And I set a goal for myself to reach one person with the message to get, if you're serious about getting a van, get moving. Because the last 10 years of our lives, typically, from what I've seen people, certainly the last five, health isn't great. And that was my parents' situation. So I'm happy to say we've overachieved the goal. Let me zoom in here for you. This is the most recent one I got. I think I just got this yesterday. But I have, I think there's three or four. This may be the fifth person that says, yep, that got me over the hump. 6,600 views of that short What's Up Wednesday last week. But Lessons with Troy leaves a really nice comment. I think you see this on the YouTube there. And what I've done here is kind of pick out one of the great phrases. This should be a t-shirt. Regret of doing it. Beginning event is less than the regret of not doing it. So we managed to push him over. You can see here he had a sleepless night, and he'd been tinkering with getting a used Travato 59K. And I'm really happy to say that working together, we helped put him over the edge to get his van. So congratulations, Lessons with Troy. Well done, sir. I just love that. The regret of doing it is less than the regret of not doing it. Well said, sir. We're going to say hi to a bunch of folks tonight. So hang tight there. Libation Live, because we're in Shiner Country. I'm not going to do it now. What do you think? There's nothing finer than a Shiner. And every drop of Shiner comes from Shiner. All right, you're right. So here's what I've done. I've been storing my glasses. These are the only glass in my van in the freezer, because every beer tastes better in a frosted mug. Right? I can't wait to go to the... I was here 4 years ago. Maybe it was even five. Oh. So every drop of Shiner comes from Shiner, and nothing finer than a Shiner, except a Shiner in a frosted Luckenbach, Texas glass. Go this way. Oh, that looks delish. Cheers, everybody. Thanks for joining us. Oh, yeah. That's delicious. Thank you for granting me that pleasure. This day in history, I've got a Bobby Gentry song for you. It's a pretty good one. And let us know where you're watching from. I see a bunch of regulars in here. And we have a super chat already. This is great. This is from Emily. Where are you, Emily? Ooh, there's a lot of stuff going on here. This is great. Right here. Emily, thank you so much for your generosity there. It helps keep the Libation Live intact. Appreciate that, Emily. Oh, great deal. Let's see. I got a couple of big announcements, and then we want to get into our meat of the matter tonight. So I've been working really hard to get my website updated. So if you can go there, I'm now including live streams. I'm starting to schedule these out. We actually have one in the morning. So be sure you're subscribing to the channel so you get notified by YouTube when we go live, because that's really the only way you're going to get to see it live like this. So tomorrow we're going to do a live tour of the Sprinter, Mercedes Sprinter-based Echo, brand new from the Super Show in January. Winnebago Motorhomes, Rockford, Illinois, my home dealer, is going to do this from there, outside of Chicago. I'm in Texas, so the magic of technology, right? So you don't want to miss that. It's at 9 a.m. Eastern tomorrow morning. Gonna be great. And then next Friday, we're gonna have Embassy RV do a live tour of one of their newest and updated Class B RVs, the Dolphin, on the ProMaster. And Terry Minix, if you've seen him, you know he's really awesome. We're gonna do that. So put those on your calendar. And if you're part of our Patreon community, it's growing like crazy. We didn't do last Friday because we had the big Van Brie in Texas Hill Country, but join us this Friday at 12 p.m. Eastern. And you can go on Patreon and get the details there about that. One more thing to mention here is this is the next upcoming Van Brie. This is the Weird Wild West. It's in Bisbee, Arizona, which is about an hour south of Tucson. We got a bunch of us going. I'm so excited. And if you go to their website, you see they got other things going. There's a caravan up in Colorado. I'm not sure which way I'm going to go. So I'm a little tentative on if I'm going to that, but it looks like a lot of fun. Buy your tickets directly from them. We're just kind of hanging out. And that's our next big Vanbury event. So that's, you don't want to miss that. Texas Hill Country. But first, we want to thank our sponsor, Sunshine State RVs, for sponsoring this segment of What's Up Wednesday. And the bonus that I promise you every week is you get to spend time with me on a Zoom call to help you talk through your van situation. And just use the QR code here, and that clicks off. You fill out the form, goes to Sunshine, and then they will give me the contact information. We've got a few folks. So that's, where is Sunshine State RVs? In Gainesville, Florida, right there in the middle of the state, northern Florida, which is great. I love them because I've actually worked on my van. They worked on my toilet, of all things. How about that for a good sponsor partner, right? But many of you have bought your vans from these folks, and you know that they're just the legit thing. All they do is Class B RVs. They will fly you in. They will deliver the van to you directly. They carry some of the best brands. Let me zoom in here for you. And they're the number one dealer for Coachmen, the number one Nova dealer of Coachmen's three rigs in the country. They're just a class act. And if you've been around them, you know they're pretty awesome people. They're actually kind of emphasizing some of their mods. And there is my van in the circle down below. That's Rover Gear. They're an authorized retailer and installer. So if you're thinking about getting ladders, bike racks, storage boxes, tire carriers, things on top of your roof, etc., be sure and hit them up for that, and they will take care of you. When you do your day of purchase, they give you a very thorough walkthrough. Corey's a great guy. Give you two nights at a campground just a few minutes away. And what they guarantee is 5 days, a service appointment within 5 days when you buy a van from them. That's a pretty big deal, ladies and gentlemen. They have a valet service, complimentary valet to the dealer for service appointments if you're within 100 miles, and free tech support. I think this is pretty groovy. A lot of times it's just a customer not quite understanding something, so they, Monday through Friday, offer you phone support, which is pretty awesome. And again, here's the bonus. Snap the QR code. If you're shopping for a van, you got to hit these guys up, put them on your short list. And then you and I can have a Zoom call before or after your purchase there. So again, just the contact me form, and a big thank you to Sunshine State RVs for sponsoring this segment of What's Up Wednesday. I'm meeting with them on Friday to talk about our next Vanbury's that they're sponsoring for us. So, all right, you ready to have some of this Texas Hill Country stuff? It's so much fun. Oh my gosh. For those of you that went, raise your hand and, It's let's say, where am I at here, Scott? I'm right here. Okay. So we're going to kind of walk through just a few things that we did in Fredericksburg, Luckenbach, Johnson City, and Lyndon Baines Johnson, Texas White House. And for those of you who went, see if you recognize any of these pictures, it's pretty funny. Okay, I'm going to zoom in here for you. We got some videos coming up too. So what we did last year, we met in the visitor center. It was not a good idea. This year we met in Walmart. So we started in Walmart, then we caravaned to Luckenbach. And when we got to Luckenbach, this is Taylor. She did a great job. She gave us a private history lesson on Luckenbach. And there I am holding my sign. It was pretty groovy. And after she was done, we all took a big photo in front of the stage. And we had day guests. We had a couple of day guests. Yes, I'm thinking right. And but most of them were campers. We had 20, 21 vans, I think, 22 maybe. And there we were all kind of sitting around the bourbon fire. It wasn't awesome weather. It got a little rainy the next day in the morning, but the sun did, we had a little van life miracle. The sun came out just at sunset. Look at that sunset. It was absolutely spectacular. And then as the evening wore on, we managed to go down to the dance hall. That's where that picture was taken earlier, and closed down the dance hall. And I will have to say that even I got myself out there and we danced around a little bit. It was pretty funny. This white boy can't dance, I can tell you that right now. But we did have a great fun time. And the song that we danced to was Willie Nelson's On the Road Again, Dancing with My Crazy Friends. And it was just one of the greatest things. And then some of us went back to the van and we're not quite ready to call a night. So there's a few of us crazies getting around the table in my van. It was pretty awesome. The next morning, our agenda was to go to Johnson City, Texas. This is the boyhood town of President Johnson. His boyhood home is actually there. So there we are in front of one of the murals. Here I'm getting a scolding by Willie that he says you should have really stuck to your guitar lessons, and I'm not disagreeing with him. There's a motorcycle museum in town, and there's Mason Mike driving Justin around. It was pretty funny. And then this is us actually at the boyhood home. We had such a big group, and we were like 30 minutes till the next one started. What they did is the Ranger Kevin, wasn't it? Came out and actually gave us a private tour of the house. It was really great. So van life miracle, right? There we are in front of the historical park. This is across the street from his boyhood home. Really interesting. Really interesting guy. And very influential. Even we still kind of feel this today. Vietnam, a huge thing with his presidency, but it was, look at all the stuff that they did for the country. Medicaid, for example. Okay, let me show you a couple more here. Let me know if you're having fun. It was so great. So this one's one of my favorite photos. This is in panoramic mode. This is after the Johnson City walking tour. We went to the Harvest Host. It was Silver Dollar Winery, just a few minutes literally out of Johnson City. And I stayed there last year, so I knew this place could handle us. We've been talking to him for months. We had, I think we had 19 vans overnight, and there we are all in the line. And I'm really bummed we didn't get a picture, but they had of the bonfire. They were nice enough to actually, they had all the seating area out there by the winery buildings, and made us a huge bonfire that was so much fun. Then we got up in the morning. Some people kind of tapped out a little early, but there's about, I don't know, 11 of us, or maybe there's about. And this is at the parking lot of the visitor center to go tour his ranch, the Texas White House. And it was pretty awesome. I got a couple videos here. Let me see if I can bring this up. You saw the one with the, let's see. Is this mine? I think this is mine right here. So what this is, I'm turning a corner. We're on the ranch, and you can see the land. There's just something about watching vans caravan around to me. I can never tire of this. Let me know if you have the same feeling. There's something about it. I can't get enough of it. This was the one when we went to the, it's all under renovation. So it's all closed. We actually got yelled at by the ranger. Cause they said, you're blocking the road, move along. You can't see stopping here. It was pretty funny. So again, all the vans lined up. And then of course we saw this one at the top of the show. This was time lapse when we were, leaving the cemetery of President Johnson, his wife, Lady Bird. Right there. And what's up? Come on, Justin. Come on. There he is. And there's Bobby. It's just a huge shout out to everybody. What I did is we put together a Dropbox folder. Many of you that attended put photos in there, including some of those. So that was really, really special and such a great time. So we're going to make this probably an annual event because I just can't get enough of Texas Hill Country. I'm kind of in here right now. I'm headed to Austin. That's what we wanted. There we go. And I just love it down here. It's pretty expensive, but Shiner's only like an hour and a half from Houston, so I'm way back down here, but I'm headed up to Austin. So with that, let's say hi to some folks. And oh my gosh, we got Sunshine State in the show tonight. Thank you, Sunshine State RVs. Did I get your ad right? Thanks again for sponsoring us. And I'm meeting with Bethany on Friday to talk through plans for the rest of the year. So thank you for that. Okay, let me zoom up here. Thank you. Let's see, it's maybe Nick that's watching. Here's Marcia. Always great to see you. And here's Ohio Sharon. Always great to see you. Windy, 46. Here's New York Ron. Good to see you, sir. Here's Sherry. She did such a great job. Tucson. I'm going to be there not too long from now. Next month. This is all about Texas this month and then Arizona next month, I think. She just did a great job. Here's Eric's in the house. Good to see you. Roads of Life. Thumbs up for Roads of Life and Go Small, Live Large. Appreciate that. There we go. here's David in the house. Good to see you, sir. David O is in the house. Good to see you, sir. Thanks for being here. Let's see. Here's John. What's up? Sebring, Florida. Good to see you. Thanks for being here. Here's Gary. Oakland Park. Orland Park. Just up the road from Kankakee. Here's a question. If you can help us out with a question format, this really helps. Three stars, three question marks. For you personally, what is the best thing to happen at an event? No breakdowns, no drama. I'm just saying, we haven't had any of that yet. It's just all of us having fun. You know, this is just a great group. We had, it was about, I don't know, 70-30 mix returning from second year or from the first year and some new folks. I love everybody. Meeting them all, it's just so great. So, and then just capturing the picture, it's so great. And then it's what personally, what's the worst thing to happen at an event? That'd be a breakdown. That would be no fun. Somebody gets stuck, although we can get that taken care of pretty easily. Maybe somebody gets hurt. That would be pretty bad. Just everybody have a good time, right? And Roads of Life. If you didn't have a black tank option, what toilet would you get? Oh boy, toilet talk. Probably Lavio is what I would steer toward. I like those a lot. Here's Peggy in the house. Good to see you. Yeah, Burr, 34. Holy cow. Scott, you planned amazing. Scott, you planned amazing meetup. Thank you to you and anyone who helped on the Luckenbach. We did have some great help. Emily at the Johnson City Visitor Bureau and Taylor at Luckenbach did a really bang up job. Yeah, every time I do one of these, I learn a few things to do and not do, do differently. And we've got a bunch more planned for like one a month this year. So it's important to visit the website. We'll do an announcement video. Let's see. Sorry, I got distracted here. And everybody just helps out. Back to your point, Sherry. People are helping me out. They're helping others out, giving van advice. Russ changed Frisco T's light bulbs. And it's just all of us coming together and just having fun. Here's Dan in the house. Here's Simi G. Good to see you. Ooh, $4.96 a gallon. Reason I might not go to California. I don't know. Here's David. Got a question. What's the best part of having chosen the van family you have created over the past 6 years? Just seeing us all come together. You know, these things are super convenient, right? But when people come together in the van breeze, it's a punctuation mark, David, on why I do what I do. And that we helped a few people get over the fence to get a van this year. It warms my heart. I'm telling you. Cause this whole thing has changed my life completely. I'm grumpy some days and I'm happier on other days than some, but, it's just this van family we've created together. Don't have the biggest channel, fine, but all of us coming together. It's just so great. And, let's see, Sunshine State RVs. This Nick, what is your favorite meal you have cooked in your van? It's a good question. I only cook about once or twice a month. I don't know. I did, we test tasted for Thanksgiving four different kinds of, those were terrible. Favorite meal I've cooked in my van. Steak, probably. I love steak. That's not really in my van. I do use cast iron. So I made, what was it? A chicken, a veal. bread and veal. So that was a good one. Love cooking on cast iron. Let me know if you agree with me or not. Here's another. This is another one. Thank you for the question there. Wow, we're getting, this is a YouTube user. Thank you. Appreciate that very much. It goes right into Libation Live. And I didn't put the picture out there because there was a lot of libation both nights. It was pretty awesome. Here's Endless Adventure. Thank you for that. Appreciate that. Look forward to seeing you in Bisbee. Thank you for that. Super Sticker, I think those are called, right? Yeah, that's so great. Let's see. Here we got Frank in the house, Bentonville. Good to see you. Here's Marie. She's going to be our guest next week. A solo female traveler in her van. She bought an Embassy RV. And so she's going to be, in fact, I need to reach out to you, young lady, and kind of walk through the topics for you, but you're going to do great. And thank you again for sharing. In fact, if you are in the audience and you want to share your story, a few of you reached out because, again, my dad thing. If you want to be a guest on the program, love to have guests, love to have van owners. So it's not just, this ain't about me at all. I'm really not that interesting, but reach out to me. My email's on my website, and you can tell us your story. And Marie next week is going to be gracious enough to share her story. I'm really excited. She's an interesting gal. She's going to do great. Yeah, you are probably freezing up there. You're used to. There's Justin in the house, still watching from Fort Worth. Good news. Remaining parts are en route, and maybe he'll be on the way. Are you having to do a hotel? Let us know about that. Justin, he's a great guy. Here's Living Free Hello from Marlboro, Massachusetts. Live Free and Van Venture. Great to have you here. Thank you. Here's Bev. Mesa, Arizona. Oh, yeah. Shiner Rocks. Yes, it does. If you haven't tried this particular Bock style beer from Shiner, you really need to give yourself a try, because it doesn't taste anything like it looks. If you don't like dark beer, you're going to probably like this. It's so smooth. I'm actually staying at the Shiner Campground, $35 tonight. I'm pretty excited about that. Thank you, Rob. Yes, you're right. Let's see. So, Ali B, I enjoy your channel. Thank you, Ali B. How many repairs have you had on your van? More repairs on the van than on the build out. I've had so few things go wrong. It's really a short list. I mean, there on the van, there was a cracked cylinder head at 49,000 miles. The battery went dead a few months ago. That freaked me out. I thought for sure something was broken badly. Just little nitpicky things. I'm trying to think. On the coach itself, Sunshine fixed the seal on my toilet after 5 years of flushing that thing. There's been so few things. Hopefully I'm not alone in having so few things go wrong. I might proactively replace the fridge, because it's been running continuously for over 5 years. It's probably not meant to do that. And the awning, I will say the awning has been a real a problem. When I got rear-ended in Fort Worth in April of last year, it threw all the alignment off and it burned out the motor, the original motor, and I had the motor replaced, and now it's not working again. So I may just take the whole damn thing off. I use it so little. I don't know. Maybe it's time to do another 127,000 miles on this thing now. It's pretty great. yes, sir. Dan Archer, when was the last time you checked your seals on the roof of your van? Have you had to clean install the Dicor lap sealant? So that's one of the problems I did have kind of early in. I check them a couple times a year. I don't do it. I have an RV expert do it. This thing did leak the max air fan on two different occasions and the bedroom window. Professional folks resealed those. But when I have a RV service department handy, I have them inspect the roof because they know what to look for. I don't. I got up there when this thing was leaking and I couldn't see where it was leaking. If you do that for, you know, leave it to the pros. I don't even have a tube of that stuff in my van. If it leaks, then we'll take it right to somebody. That's or mobile RV technician, I've had super great luck with them. But I highly recommend having that inspected a couple, three times a year, for sure. Here's Emily. Have a cocktail, me. Saw here by dad. Thank you, Emily. Appreciate that. Are you new to the program, Emily? I don't know. Glad to have you here. Either way. Thoughts on Gretsch vans. They're nice vans. They're kind of a Cadillac brand, I would say, right? Really well made. They have a good lithium system in it. Does Sunshine State RV sell Gretsch? It's definitely a premium brand, but they're beautiful. They're, I'm probably going to not get it right, but I often see them on the short Sprinter, but they probably build them on others, but I don't know that they put them on, Ford Transit. Beyond the Fern, checking in from home base. How's it feel to be home? Ready to get back on the road? here's Sherry Ann from Buford, Georgia. I love Georgia. That's a great state. Here's Jay Diamond. Have you ever boondocked at a hospital? I stayed at one on my way home from Sunshine State RV. Had a great night's sleep. You know, I haven't. I get asked that often. I would probably sleep on the street. Really, my van. Urban camping. Discreet parking on the street in the right kind of place. Why? Maybe it's just my Catholic guilt. I don't want to be one of those people that makes a sign go up. Or you have to, you know, get a pass and stuff like that. And a number of you folks have done this. I just haven't. And that's why I prefer to be on the street. I am much happier. That is great. thank you, Sunshine State RVs, being on the show tonight. I need to have you guys back. Talk with Bethany about that this Friday. Jerry, hello. This is Jerry from Boulder, Colorado. This will be my first time live with you. Thank you, Jerry, very much. This is for you. It's a pleasure to have you here. This is great. There's Van Liberty in the house. John Stanton. We're going to see you in Bisbee, right, sir? Yeah, gas keeps going up. It's kind of expensive around here for Texas. There's actually a refinery flare just over the horizon here. You can just see the flames. It's pretty cool. I like being in gas country, you know, oil industry country. Louisiana's got a lot of it. It just reminds me of if we all just turned the spigot off on the gasoline situation, we'd be back to Stone Age in about 2 minutes. I don't think that industry gets the credit they kind of deserve. Ain't gonna be around forever, but Beyond the Fern, congrats to Lessons with Troy. Many happy travels with you. Yes, I'm so here's how would this work. So a lot of folks have chat amongst yourselves in the chat here, which is great. Just love it. Here's Roger and Jane. Thank you for being here. Yeah, it's pretty great. Let's see. Here's Steve. Louisville Steve. Good to see you, sir. Here's, the way. Marlena. Hi, Scott from Marlena and Carlos. Hot Springs, Arkansas. We enjoy the Hill Country Roundup. Safe travels. They had so much fun. Just great folks, right? Blow the trumpet for total mobility. Yes, sure. Let's see. Excuse me. Yes, we're all headed to Bisbee. Well, many of us, I should say. Yeah, Roger and Jane, thank you. 40,000. Just crossed that last week, a couple weeks ago. And I just got a notification, 8.5 million views of my content. So it takes a family, right? It takes us all working together to pull this stuff off. So look for questions. Here's Jack, Georgia Jack. At my age, here's another lesson I've learned and preach frequently. Don't wait too long to retire. Yeah. Right? Yeah, try great advice, Jack. He's a great guy. Are you going to Bisbee with us, Georgia Jack? Travato Traveler, hello from Fayetteville, Arkansas. Suggestions on van sliding door lubricant. I use WD-40, the dry kind that doesn't attract grit. And I probably spray that on the tracks, on the wheels, a couple times a month, actually. Depends how much rain it's gotten. Just think how many times this slider, I'm pointing at the sliding patio door, that thing has been open. I use it 90% of the time versus the front driver. Even if I'm just... like even a gas station, I'm using this door for some reason. It's just crazy. I don't know why. So try that. Some of you might have some other thoughts on brand. I tried to spray graphite. Don't do that. Oh God, I'm still getting the graphite off the van. I'm not sure what I was, thank you for that question, driving in today down here to Shiner. But I got out, walked around, and on this side of the van, the driver's side, I must have hit an oil patch, like on new road construction or something, because I got oil all over my wheel wells and the side of the van. I thought something kind of broke when I got out. I'm like, what in the heck? And I looked in the engine compartment expecting to see a bunch of oils, like something, a hose broke, but no warning lights or anything. So this side of the van, the passenger side is clean. The other side is got oil. It's really, so I'll have to find a car wash tomorrow. Gary's agreeing with you, Jack. let's see. Jay Diamond, let's get that taken care of. Congratulations for buying your van from Sunshine State RVs. There's two folks, I think three actually. I'm meet with Bethany from Sunshine on Friday. We're going to get all these teed up. So congratulations, Jay Diamond. Let us know what you bought. Thank you for buying it at Sunshine State RVs, our good friends. So yeah, don't wait to retire. Peggy's moving hers up. Yeah, it's just so important, right? microphone lady, Pam, what's up? We did not do a YouTube live from camp this time. We were just having too much fun and I wasn't in the mood. So, but we're trying to do those going forward. Oh, you do? So Sherry's got a photo of the winery bonfire, but try uploading Dropbox. Cell data has been iffy lately. We'll try and get that done soon. It was really a nice, they really went all out for us and the food was pretty good too. Beyond the Fern, who has a YouTube channel, as does Roads of Life, all about their van experience. Love seeing the line of vans. Yeah, like a bunch of gypsies going down the highway. It's so true, right? Yeah, Rob, I'm not getting any closer, though. I'm turning around, head the other way, because I got to get a cat. That's my next thing. Here's Cara. Good to see you here. We got a big group in here tonight. This is great. Here's Bobby. Hey, YouTube user. Hey to your wife. That's so funny. What prompted you to start van life? Explore the 51 snow? Boy, that's a good question. Bored, dumb with status quo. A long Chicago commute to an over air-conditioned cubicle. Worked with great people, but my passion wasn't in that. And I was looking for something different. And not sure what that was. And I ran across Van Life Miracle. It was a Revel ad. And I'm like, what? And then that kind of got me searching YouTube, discovered where the Russos, Less Junk, More Journey, Keep Your Daydream, you know, some of the YouTubers back then. And I'm like, what? You can build a business out of this whole thing? You can quit your job? You can travel? And the more I looked at it, the more I'm like, that's cool. And I had my corporate job all the way from 2018 until 2021. I did my corporate job. I did go part-time because of COVID. We had to downsize. And when things sprung back, like, hey, we can put you, I'm like, get me on part-time, please. That's just fine. And so I exited corporate America in September of 2021. And while not every day out here is sunshine and rainbows, it's sure better than the best day at the office in a lot of ways. So just searching for legacy, explore the 50, searching for meaning, searching for doing things that I enjoy, which is travel, not on an airplane and hotels and rail cars, horrible. And I wanted to help people discover things that I had discovered. And, you know, that's why we're the Russos. Kate and Joe are just always going to be my hero because they trailblaze a path I didn't know existed. And many of you, I've done that for you, like they did it for me. So, my only regret is not having done it sooner. This isn't going to go on forever. but it's changed my life forever. Good question, sir. Love you. Yes. Let's see. Here's Christopher. That might be a new name. Samino. Hi. Thanks for joining us tonight. Appreciate that. Any good Eclipse meetups? Yeah, we have a top secret one we're working on. I'm getting increasingly, my anxiety meter is going way up. So we're not disclosing the location we're going to be at. There's a few on Patreon that know that location. We're probably going to shift it. While we were in Leukenbach, which is going to be in the Path of Totality in Johnson City, Texas, there's increasing chatter of, just the place can be overrun with people, and I don't want to have people follow me. And we get in some stampede or something like that. So it's a very small group. We'll probably an update this week for those of you that already have that information. It's going to relocate from to northern Texas. So stay tuned on that. But it's going to be interesting. I mean, it's going to be interesting, which kind of makes me a little nervous. Here's Neil and Britt in Santa Fe, New Mexico. Love that town. So Transit. Hi, Scott. Will there be a meetup in the Midwest? Agnes. Yes, for sure. Stay tuned. That's quite a ways out. So I'm just trying to get the next couple of months planned. But absolutely. You ladies are going to Alaska. You will not see me in Alaska. I got no interest. Melbourne, Australia. How's it going, Pen Pen? That's cool. What time of day is it? What day is it? Right? Oops. A bad day of van life is still better than a good day of office life, 100%. And you just retired too, right, Frisco? Roads of Life. Scott, you don't need to have the biggest channel. You have the biggest heart. Yes, sir. I appreciate that. Thank you. This is for you, Rob. And the jingle jar game, if you're playing that, means you have to have a drink. That suggestion came from Roads of Life. Where in the world is Justin? He's in Fort Worth getting his rig work done. That's been a journey. Excuse me. David Green. I love the meetup we had at Winnebago Motorhomes near Rockford. It was one of the best days, for real. I think about it often. I still chat with some of the other folks there. And that's, thank you, David. It's so many contacts were exchanged over the 3 days, two nights, and now they're all planning ghosts. Again, this isn't about me. I'm just kind of the hub of the wheel, but y'all are making campground plans and van brie plans and caravan plans, and I'm not in the middle of it, which is fine. And that's just the way it works. It's so great. A can of Shinerbach, you got it. No problemo. And it's exported out of Texas to most of the states. In fact, you find it at Walmart often now, which is pretty cool. It's hard to find cans. Cans definitely work better in my RV fridge. I prefer bottles, but putting a glass kind of solves that problem. But I will definitely. Here we got Jerry Minchie in the house from Costa Rica. Oh, yeah. Good to see you, Jerry. Prolific author. Here's Quebec, Canada in the house. looks like you're ready for those bears, Scott. Oh, yeah, right there, for sure, right? Or bad people. Let's see. Christopher wants to know, what is the one item that you would recommend for new van lifers? I would say a few things. I would highly recommend a Harvest Host membership. Takes you a place you wouldn't necessarily go. You get to meet the maker, and it's one of the best programs. One item you would recommend for van lifers. I'm not sure there's a specific item. Man, you can draw a blank on me there. Harvest Host, if you really want to explore, there's some good apps out there. I'm sure there's one item. Maybe somebody can help me out. It's really kind of not having a bunch of items. I have empty space in my cupboards back here. One item, I would get a laundry bag. Oh, that's so. I would get a laundry bag, put the laundry detergent and the bag of quarters in the laundry bag. So it's always with you. I would get your shower house bag, gym bag, and put everything you need in it. That can be taken to the shower house or to the gym in a moment's notice. Towel, everything, your little dope kit, whatever they call those things, with your razor and what have you. I would also come up with a system for doing your tanks and electricity. So there's a couple like adapters you probably want to get for electricity. So if there's only a 50 amp available, you can put an adapter on it to plug in 50 amp and then it converts to 30 amp. So a few things like that are pretty neat and necessary, but good question. That'd be a good question for you to do a video about, right? Deborah's in freezing Michigan. This is great. Frisco T, Ray, be back on the road. That's funny. Here's Susan. This might be a new one too. Hi, Susan. Thanks for, oh yeah, first time live chat. Connecticut. We had people from all over. I think North Carolina was the furthest east. Quite a few from Florida. Wisconsin was the most northern, I think. Minnesota. And California. So they came from all over the country for the Van Brie. It was awesome. Endless adventures. How long did it take you to reach 100 subs? A long time, strangely. I don't remember the exact, but you know, a couple months. I didn't know it. I was making videos about vans. I didn't even have a van yet. I was so excited. I just wanted to get it going. And 40,000. I do remember hitting 10,000 in Boise. That's been a few years ago. I've been seeing some comments, though, that YouTube is unsubscribing people from this channel automatically. I've heard another RVer, the Endless RVing, had a post similar that viewers were reaching out saying, hey, what happened? This, I'm being unsubscribed. So I have to dig into this a little bit. I'd love to grow faster, but it's really the views, view duration that really matters, not the subscribers. It's kind of a vanity thing for us content creators. But it's bad measurement of what YouTube wants, which is how many views are being seen on the videos and how much of the video is being seen. Those are the two measures. Like, put ads in there, right? If you don't like the ads, I get it. Just subscribe to YouTube. It's like, I don't even know, $14 a month, 15 bucks a month, and all the ads go away. But the ads keep the lights on and the server farms running. So here's a tip. I like blaster lubricant for when my awning gets sticky. Good to know that. And Jack is going to see us in the bourbon tour. So we're going to do a Van Brie in Kentucky at the Kentucky Bourbon Festival. Can't wait for that. That's here's Pen Pen from Australia. Hey, Endless. I don't have a van yet, but everyone I follow here in Australia loves it. So we are big. We are so big. It take years to go around Australia. It's bigger than the continental U.S. Maybe. Eric, that's kind of an interesting idea. Check your CV boots for cracks. Sometimes gear oil might cover your wheel wells. Yeah, I looked at it's really weird the way it works. I'll check a little closer tomorrow. Maybe I'll run into a Ram dealer. And if you're on my Patreon, you saw that I really had a fantastic experience at a Ram dealer just this last week on Thursday morning before the Van Brie. So maybe I'll run into a Ram dealer to see what they think. How do you find a good mobile RV tech? Bev wants to know. There is a website where all the accredited ones, you can locate them by state. I can't remember what the name is off the top of my head, but if you look for like a Google search, that would bring some up for sure. If there's a campground in your area, like a KOA or a commercial campground, they usually have business cards. I would phone the that campground and have them give you some of their favorites, because they're not going to talk about or put cards out for people that aren't good at being mobile RV tech. So I've had some really good luck over the years with that. Campground recommendations. Good question. And if it's something standard, like, you know, the ceiling fan, water pump, what else have they done? Those are basic systems that they should know. The technician should know a lot about. Wow, this is great. Hi, Karen. A lot of firsts in here tonight. This is great. Been watching for a few years. First time I made a live. Thanks for being here. Here's one for you. Just appreciate you being here. Here's CMG. Ooh. Scott, when you urban camp on a resident street, what time do you wake up and leave the area? Great question. CMG, thank you for that, sir. Very generous. Keeping the libations pouring. When I post the place I stay, verified okay, on my Patreon site. So if you're a true believer, you can get that information on the sites that I stayed at. For example, I was just in a small town in the Texas Hill Country, stayed across from City Hall and the police station. Pretty safe, right? I roll in fairly late. What I don't want to do is have a bunch of lights on and kind of making dinner and everything and calling attention to myself. I don't stay in front of somebody's house because what's this big old thing in front of my house about that just is calling attention to myself? I don't want that. And then I scoot along pretty early in the morning. Now it's getting light around 7:30 a.m. here Central Time. I don't like driving at dark in the dark. But as soon as that sun starts coming up and it's making a difference, I go to some place, a city park parking lot or a Planet Fitness, something like that. Clean the teeth and what have you. So I don't really meander. I don't linger in an urban camping situation in the morning, and I kind of roll in late. I've scoped it out during the daytime, and I go back and we've done a few videos on this. You don't want to stay on Main Street, stay off the main drag a little bit. Next to an apartment building's pretty safe bet. There's a lot of traffic there, so you won't stand out bad. But kind of roll in late and roll out early would be my suggestion. Let's see, here's Jean. New to your chat. This is Gene. I've been following for about 2 years, I think. What's going on with Wingham? Not hearing much about them lately. We're going to have some updates with them in a month or two. So hang tight. They're working really hard to get the rigs over here. Way behind schedule. Maybe not surprising, but they're coming. So it's 10:30 in the morning in Melbourne. You're drinking coffee, we're drinking beer. I don't know, Texas is pretty funny. Let's see. Roland Rockstar, have you been to Texas yet? Port Aransas? No. I've been to Texarkana. That's a tiny town that's kind of move along. Although there's El Dorado, Arkansas, that's super cool, just up the road. I've not been to this place you mentioned here. Have I seen the Northern Lights? Yeah, when I was a kid, actually, I have seen those. Those are pretty special. so here's Karen. Thanks for all the questions tonight. How are we doing on time? Ooh. Let me get a few more questions, and then I just want to share the this day in history. Some interesting things there. Karen says, I'm ready to buy my first RV and decided on a van. Lots of weekends and a few weeks a year. Love the Nova, but I decided I need to go use. Is there anything twin beds that I could get under $100,000? My place would be to see what Sunshine State RVs has got rocking and rolling. I would go to rvtrader.com and they have good search tools, and you can put in all kinds of different criteria, filter by that, and see what is available. You can definitely get a van for $100,000, no doubt about it. I'm a flat no on Alaska. No interest. Gonna take an Alaskan cruise out of Seattle to Alaska. That's my speed. Justin, what happens in Lukenbach stays in Lukenbach. Yeah, it's pretty funny. Just look for some questions. Uh, Oh, this is a good one. They're all good. Kathmandu. Hi, Scott. When you travel, do you encounter any allergy sensitivities? I've got pollen reactions twice. Florida first, a few weeks later, I see things blooming in North Carolina. It took 2 years of being on the road full-time going through spring and fall for my body to get adjusted. The second year was worse than the first year because what was happening, I was rolling out of Florida and rolling into spring. It got so bad the second year, I think it was. When I got to Chicago, I went to the ear, nose, throat doctor. And I'm like, what is going on with my seasonal allergies? So he's like, well, where'd you come from? He's like, you've been in 3 months of spring. Everything's blooming as you're moving forward or moving north. And I'm like, all right, you got a pill for that? And not really. So my body's, I'm happy to say, is adjusted. Although there's some tree pollen down here that's oak, I think it is, that's a little more problematic, but and the same with mosquitoes. I used to have vicious reactions to mosquitoes because they're localized. Mosquitoes a mosquito, right? But they're localized to their own style, and my body's really adjusted pretty well for mosquito bites, which I'm really happy about because mosquitoes love me. Good question. Keep the Zyrtec handy. All right, let's do this. Let me, good question. So let me just share this day in history. We always like to do this. It's always kind of fun. This day in history. I'll zoom in here for you. So I had actually had to think twice about this. 2003, 21 years ago, the United States invades Iraq. And that is not Desert Storm. That was back in the 90s, right? And then 102 years ago, the USS Langley is commissioned as the first United States Navy aircraft carrier. Biplanes, probably, right? I don't know. And this is kind of interesting. 172 years ago, Harriet Beecher Stowe's Uncle Tom's Cabin is published. And that is some of the reason, according to Wikipedia, that things started percolating around the Civil War was because of that book about slaves and plantations and all that stuff. So kind of interesting. And this is our thumb up, please. Appreciate that. And this is our record of the song of the week. And if you haven't heard this in a while, this is a great song, Ode to Billy Joe. It was released in 1967. I was 2 years old. It was number one song for 5 weeks. It was nominated for 8 Grammys. So I haven't heard Ode to Billy Joe. She's got a beautiful voice, and it's just a guitar singing. It's just acoustical. It's just really, really great. All right, let's see if we have a few more questions here. And then, I don't have any interest in going here either. There's so much to do in the United States and Canada, for that matter. So, Scott, do people have any problems with hoses hooked up under the vans getting ripped out or snapped off running over things in the road? We have lots of dead kangaroos and wombats. What the heck's a wombat in Australia? I would say it's not so much roadkill that's a problem. It's obstacles in parking lots, curbs, really deep driveways. Those things will take a sewer system out for sure. But I've never, if you ran over something that's pretty big, I would probably not be great for your van, anything underneath it. So I'm always super cautious of what's ahead of me. Like tire tread on the highways. Well, you guys are all busy here. Thank you for this tonight. Appreciate it. Time to toast to those of us who finally retiring this year to follow in your tire tracks. Thanks for all the fellowship and inspiration. You are welcome, Pam. And thank you. It takes us all working together. It's here's Sam. How are you, sir? Solomon, sorry. Thank you for that. This guy tried to chase me down and give me some bourbon. I snuck out of Florida before I got to see him. So thank you, sir. I appreciate it. We're gonna see you soon in a van, right? thank you for that super sticker. I appreciate it. Did I do that already? Really appreciate it. Super generous. Okay, you all are planning to go to Alaska. A horrible pollen in Gainesville. And it's everything is starting to bloom. It's really pretty. It's just so funny. In Florida, it's kind of endless summer, literally. And I think it's magic to watch things come to life. I really did kind of miss that in Four Seasons. Things die in the winter and they kind of come back to life. And you don't have that experience in Florida. It's just always growing. Thanks to God, the tape measure exercise really drove things home the other day. Yeah, you're welcome. It's pretty interesting. And if you have great health late in life, that's amazing. A lot of us won't, unfortunately. We don't really have a lot to do with that. Here's Ricky. Had a movie also in the 70s. I'm not sure what that is. Here's a question for Sunshine. State RVs, do you install things like bumpers on Sprinters? Kind of the aftermarket adventure van gear stuff. Yeah, they've got you covered there, probably. What in the heck's a wombat? They're apparently really cute. I don't know. Yeah, Peggy's on the bourbon. So it's the Bourbon Festival in Kentucky. So there's tickets. I would secure some camping. I'm at the state park. It's just outside of town. That's kind of in town, actually. That's all sold out. But we will be posting. It's mid-September. And it's in Bardstown, Kentucky. So you don't want to miss that. More on that soon, as soon as they post that. But try and secure a reservation for you as soon as you can. How's the gym program coming along? Mason Mike wants to know. Yeah, not great today or yesterday. Or I think once I get back up there, it's really been a couple weeks of super lows and super highs. So I'm all out of cattywampus. But thank you for asking. All right, folks. So we are at time. Is this what we're looking for here? Look for the NRVIA for RV inspectors. It's something like an acronym like that. I should find that and put that on my website to reference for folks. It's a good idea. Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching another What's Up Wednesday. We have Marie on next week, solo female traveler. Trading out of a Travato into an Embassy RV. She's super pumped. And we got a lot more great guests coming up over the coming weeks. So months and weeks, I should say. So with that, we say thank you, everybody, for watching. Big group in here tonight. A lot of new folks. Appreciate that. That's super great. And we'll have another video releasing on Sunday. And keep an eye on things for Van Breeze meetups, meet and greet, roundups, things like that, and Patreon, Zoom, and all that business. So my website is kind of home central for all that. So thank you, everybody, for watching. We'll see you soon, and we like to say peace. Let me get this off the screen. Peace be with you. Thanks for watching.